नमस्ते, आई एम जेवी डॉक्टर सपना गहलोत एंड माय सेशन इज ऑन सोवरेनिटी मीनिंग डेफिनेशन एंड द डायमेंशंस. ओके, सोवरेनिटी इज अ कंसेप्ट ऑफ मॉडर्न पॉलिटिकल थ्योरी. द ग्रीक्स हैड नो आइडिया ऑफ दिस टर्म सोवरेनिटी. एरिस्टॉटल यूज्ड द टर्म सुप्रीम पावर ऑफ द स्टेट इन अ डिफरेंट सेंस. ड्यूरिंग मिडल एजेस द ज्यूरिस्ट द थियोलॉजियंस एंड अदर राइटर यूज टर्म्स लाइक द सुम्मा पोटेस्टा विच मीन्स हाइएस्ट पावर ऑफ द स्टेट और प्लान्यूटो प्रोटेस्टेटस मीन सुप्रीम अथॉरिटी ऑफ अ स्टेट इन अ सेंस डिफरेंट फ्रॉम वट वी मीन नाउ बाय द टर्म ऑफ सोवरेनिटी. द क्रेडिट फॉर यूजिंग एंड ऑल्सो डिफाइनिंग दिस टर्म गोज टू बॉदा ऑफ फ्रांस हु इन सिक्स बुक्स ऑन द रिपब्लिक इन 1576 यूज द टर्म सोवरेनिटी दैट केम टू हैव इट्स इंग्लिश इक्विवेलेंट इन द वर्ड सोवरेनिटी. इन वर्ड्स In other words, you can say that sovereignty is a supreme power of the state over citizens and subjects. It's unrestrained by law. In the words of Willoughby, sovereignty is the supreme will of the state. Even the Lasky say, the sovereignty of the state issues orders to all men and all association within its area. It receives order from none of them. It will his subjects to no legal limitation of any kind. What it proposes is rightly by mere announcement of intention. Actual sovereignty in a simple terms, it is a signified supreme authority of the state and it has two dimensions. The first is internal and the another is a external. The idea of sovereignty in the internal sphere means that the state has a highest authority within the area under its control. All people and their associations are under the control of the state. In patent terms, you can say it signifies power of the state to make and enforce of law throughout its territory. It is the final power to command and enforce obedience and is subject to no legal limitations. The next is it's a internal one. Yani the idea of sovereignty after the internal, you say the idea of sovereignty in external sphere implies freedom of state from any alien of subjection or control. A dependent people cannot be called a state because they have lived and have to act according to the will of another state. But if a state accepts limitations on its freedom of action in pursuance of some international treaty or agreement, it does not amount to the loss or destruction of its sovereignty. These may be treated or self-impose limitations. So, the association of a sovereign state with a Commonwealth of Nations or with the United Nations may be referred to in this connection. If so, external aspect of sovereignty is just as an extension of its internal aspects in the international sphere. So, what you have seen, to humne kya dekha ki what is sovereignty, meaning definition and the dimension, the internal and external.